Last time we built two heat pumps in series, and today it finally runs. But I didn't do it alone. Our plumber joined me to make the home radiator circuit right, and together we are getting closer to perfection. Two different disciplines, the ancient skill of mastering water flow with the development of new principles, but one driver, curiosity to make things better. For the first time, I feel confident that the double thermal energy storage, or TES, is reliably coupled with the central heating network, even a new function, not only heating, but also cooling. Today we are showing what two affordable heat pumps can do when they work together. This is not only for the rich. DIY is the key to sustainable comfort.
Hello, I'm Norbert. I'm an energy engineer since 35 years. And in the past I was with the project, energy project with the European Commission, and I worked also for big enterprises to save energy. And now I'm dedicated to you, homeowners, to save energy. I see that also the energy transition is not going so quickly in the big organizations. So I hope that you homeowners, let's make it a democratic movement from the bottom up. Okay, in the last week we saw this video where I explained this system with a double thermal energy storage with here the heat pump. And then I explained that in the warm tank that you can use it in the winter to heat your home with the radiators, really the central heating system. And to do that, you must put an other radiator inside the hot water, and then the water which circulates through the radiators in the home, they will also circulate in this submerged radiator and then pick up the heat, and then it will be distributed in the home. The advantage of this is that you have 1,000 liter of water. If you take a temperature difference of 10 degrees only, then you have 12 kilowatt hours of energy there. And that is something you can use to store energy, excess energy from the PV. And you can also use it to run in a case of a blackout. These are 12 volt pumps that can run on the battery. Now, this is a continuation of last week's video where I explained the concept, and now let's see what results we have from that. I will now explain step for step how I pick the heat from this tank of 1000 liter, where warm water is now only 27 degrees because I started a few hours ago to charge it with the heat pump. But I will explain you how I pick up the heat. And here again, the work which I did with the plumber today. I am grateful for him, for his good and serious work. So this is the cold return of the radiator circuit, and this is the input for the radiators. So this is warm and this is colder. And that is close to the valve from the rest from this pickup circuit. Then you see a T here, an open T without valve, that is connecting to this pipe, and that is to level out, to have a constant small pressure. But it's also a kind of expansion circuit, and here you see it. Here's the bottle, I can put it higher or lower. Thank you. So this pump is sending the water inside the circuit, and it is cooling from here. And it comes from this radiator, which is submerged in the water tank of 1,000 liters of warm water. And then it comes inside the radiator. And it is sent to this radiator by this pump, the second pump, and it is coming from the return. Let's now see the influence of this on that. So this is 9 and we are at 1.6. 11, 1.6, 1.7.
Twelve volt,
33 volt, and here I see 2.1. So now we are at 10 volt for the motors, for the pumps, 8.7 liters per minute. And that's not bad. Another part of the job of the experiment was, of course, to insulate this big tank. I did it with rock wool. You can do it in many ways, but I think this is good. You must be sure that this will not get wet. And also this box, this water box, where the heat exchanger of the heat pump is. So this is the condenser which is here inside. And then you have this tank, and that's the cold tank. And that is from where the heat pump is taking the heat. So this is also really part of the storage circuit. So indeed you have here 2,000 liters of storage instead of only 1,000 liters. Okay, this water after some hours has gone from let's say 16 degrees to 13 degrees. This is icing. If you look here, you see there is icing, ice formation. And here, if I go here with my hand, then I don't feel the metal part of the heat exchanger. I feel just one surface of ice. And that means that this water is too cold and it will be difficult to extract heat. So what I did is, and that is the reason that I put in the thumbnail these two locomotives. Because here in the cellar, there is another heat pump, and it's a swimming pool heat pump. And I told it already the sense of it in the last video. And it will preheat the water, which is in a cold tank, in such a way that this will not be at 13 degrees, but let's say at a swimming pool temperature, 28 degrees. And even if it will not come there, because the swimming pool heat pump is a little bit weaker than this heat pump here. It's 500 watts and this is 650 watts. But the heat pump for the swimming pool, it is heating up the water. So the outlet will be 4 degrees higher than the inlet. And if you bring this water in this pipe, it will fall in this heat exchanger, the evaporator, and that will never ice again. And it will be, it can be at any temperature between 15 or 20 degrees or maybe 25 degrees. And that will mean that this heat pump here will have less work to do. And you will get a much higher clock. And if you look in the spreadsheet which I give with this video, and which you can see below, you will see that the combined COPs the coefficients of performance of this heat pump and the other one together, they will be better than the COP of one single, even if you have to supply power to both of them. So that means we will go down in the cellar and switch on the other heat pump, so that the warm outlet of the swing pool heat pump will go directly to this evaporator. It will not go right into the tank, which would also be a good idea, but it's really a kind of optimization that it goes first to the evaporator.
So here's the heat pump, the swimming pool heat pump. Ta-da! And there it goes. So it's the set point is 28. You saw it because it was blinking at the start. And it's now off, the heat pump. The cold water is coming in. And that is from that cold tank. And this is the warm water. So it is the water outlet you see here written. And this will send it to the evaporator of the cold of the heat pump. And okay, when I switch it on, it will make some noise. And here it will give a lot of cold air. And what I made here, I told you already about the harvest. And this is the system. These are two shelves, big shelves, with each shelf 300 kilograms. And that means that if I count the 10 kilograms for each of this container, I can put here nearly a ton. And if I put 15 kilograms, it will be 1.2 ton of piers in these double cells. And why two cells, one behind each other? Because then you have the principle that it is easier to insulate a cube. If you put these cells side to side, it will ask much more insulation, and it will be a bigger surface, and there will be more loss of cold. So it's better to put this behind the other, and then you have 1 meter from here to there, and then you can calculate how much containers you can put on each shelf. And then I can put this heat pump, I can put here on the upper side, and then it will blow here. And its radiator room is, of course, from the ceiling to this, and then it will just blow. And I will make a kind of labyrinth in such a way that it will go down on the other levels, and etc. It will arrive down. And then I will have to insulate a much smaller place than if I insulate this whole room. So that's a way to use also in the colder months the double energy of that heat pump there above, and also of this one, that you have the heat and the cold are both used, and they are both stored, because this is a kind of store with 1 ton of pears that is really the same mass on the storage capacity, more or less, than as one of those tanks, which is there above, which is also 1 ton of water. And then, because there are many months that you have to heat the house, and you need the heat of that warm tank, but at the same time, these pears, and also the apples, they want a temperature of about 0 to 3 degrees Celsius.
And that means there are many months that you need both the heat and the cold. This is the insulation material. It's polystyrene, but not expanded, but extruded. That has a lower conduction, so it's a better material for insulation. And it's also more resistant to the humid, which comes from the piers. So it's flashing at 28, that's the set point. And then after that it will indicate the temperature of the water. It's at 12 degrees. That's the water which is now already going through these pipes, because the water is already flowing. You saw before that the water was going on the evaporator that came from this heat pump. The heat pump was still switched off, and the water is already flowing, and that's good because the heat pump wants to have this cooling. So we will wait until it starts. There it goes. So, that is it for today. I hope you like it. Then you can put your thumbs up, you can subscribe to the channel. And you can also go into the description to see the spreadsheet, which is free. You just sign up for the newsletter, and then I will give you useful news, useful tips for you. And I will not block you every day with a new email. It will just sometimes come if I think I have something very interesting to add to sell to you, for example, in the form of knowledge. Okay, then the next time I will make the measurements, I will see how much juice I can get of this installation, and well, then it should be finished. Maybe not the insulation and the whole cool box in the cellar, but at least you will see this working, and I will show you also how the radiators in the house will get warm. I have also to install still the fans under the radiators in such a way increase the capacity. So those are things that I have still to do. This will be the next week. And again, I want to thank our plumber Claudio, which shows that he is really interested in innovation. So I wish you good energy.